Now, over the past months, and particularly in the weeks since the South Korean government announced its decision to deploy a sophisticated U.S. missile defense system in the southern part of this country, there have been a lot of talk surrounding that decision. Not only within this country, but all over the world, with foreign media publishing articles and commentaries showing great interest with keywords like THAAD, South Korea, China, and the U.S. But what's missing, though, and at the core of all this, is North Korea's nuclear threat. Tonight, we take an in-depth look on what the heated debate is all about. But first, let's begin with the most basic question. What is THAAD? Now, THAAD stands for Terminal High Altitude Area Defense. It's a missile defense system designed to intercept short- and medium-range ballistic missiles, the kind that North Korea launches every now and then, at an altitude beyond what the current PAC-3 system can reach, of up to 150 kilometers. Now, each THAAD system is composed of three major components: the radar, the command and control center, and the missile launcher. So, in a scenario of North Korea launching a missile toward South Korea, the battery's radar will detect the launcher launch a missile and then destroy the enemy missile before it hits the ground. So how does China fit in the picture? Well, the reason why China so strongly opposes the deployment of THAAD to South Korea is the radar component of the system. Now, this is the regular capability of what's to be deployed here, a terminal-based radar. Its effective range, a 600-kilometer radius, with a detection range of 800 to 900 kilometers at most. South Korea and the U.S. citing this have repeatedly said Seoul's THAAD deployment is purely defensive of nature against North Korea's nuclear threats.
To protect our citizens and U.S. forces Korea from North Korea's weapons of mass destruction and ballistic missiles, the two allies have decided to deploy THAAD to the Korean Peninsula.
2 years since the U.S. forces Korea first proposed the idea, and 5 months since Seoul and Washington began formal negotiations, the two sides finally announced the decision to deploy an advanced U.S. missile defense system in South Korea.
Deploying THAAD to the Korean Peninsula will improve our missile defense posture, which is a critical aspect of our defensive strategy.
It came on the heels of a fourth nuclear test by North Korea in January, followed by a series of missile launches in subsequent months. Since then, the deployment of THAAD to the Korean Peninsula has been a hot potato both in and outside of this country. So, does South Korea need THAAD?
The main concept of ballistic missile defense is multi-layered defense, they call it, because one weapon or equipment cannot perfectly destroy the incoming missiles. But as you know, we are in the danger of North Korean nuclear attack. We cannot miss any nuclear missiles. So we need to increase the destruction rate to 100%. So we need another layer of ballistic missile defense.
Then why does the U.S. want its THAAD battery in South Korea? First and foremost, to defend U.S. forces in South Korea.
The problem we have is that North Korea has about 1,000 ballistic missiles that it could fire at South Korea. And it appears to have probably now between 30 and 50 nuclear weapons. We're trying to do both, protect our people and also protect the South Korean people, both against an invasion of the North and against North Korean's missiles.
Of course, there are those who support the decision, and there are those who oppose the deployment of THAAD within this country. In the most recent poll taken among South Korean adults of 19 years of age and older, however, more than half said they were in favor of THAAD coming to South Korea. While South Korea stands firm that the deployment of THAAD is solely to protect the nation and the people from North Korean threats, China and, to a lesser extent, Russia strongly opposes Seoul's decision. Are such fears of THAAD by China justified?
China is the number three nuclear weapon state in the world. It has over 60 military satellites looking down South Korea every time, every day, and it has numerous nuclear weapons that can destroy any time in all neighboring states.
China deploys a missile system called the HQ-19, which is almost identical to THAAD. It's there to defend China against North Korean missiles. So China already has a THAAD-like system that they have deployed and been using for years.
Experts say the real reason behind China's strong opposition does not have much to do with South Korea.
Chinese policymakers themselves know clearly what they argue is unilateral and illogical. They know that already. But unfortunately, this is a structural, there are structural reasons why China continues to that argument. In this situation, China is actually playing game against the United States. You know.
South Koreans decided to deploy THAAD anti-missile defensive system in South Korea. And being a sovereign state, South Korea clearly has a right to do so. However, it does not mean that other states like China or Russia, which are sovereign state as well, are going to be happy about such decisions.
Still, they say, for China, it may be a structural decision, but for South Korea, it's a matter of life and death. They say the situation calls for the highest level of diplomacy because...
Do you have any other reliable means to protect our country and people from North Korean nuclear missile threat?
Therefore, it's critical for China to realize that only through a more flexible approach based on reality rather than ideology can this issue be resolved. Early next month, South Korean president travels to Russia and China. She's set for a one-on-one with Russian President Vladimir Putin in China. We have no word as of yet on whether the leaders of Seoul and Beijing will sit down for discussions. But how those meetings will progress and what may or should ideally come out of them, our Oh Jung-hee takes a closer look.